Good morning and welcome to the next segment of the Top 20 Patterns for Beginners. This is a part of a greater kit. This is part of the Hareline Dubbin fly tying kit. Top 20 Patterns for Beginners. Everything you need in one box material wise. They do offer a different kit that does include tools and such, but we're working with the kit with no tools included. Anyways, we recently got these kits out to each and every one of my participants with my local Project Healing Waters program. It was a great opportunity to support them while we are all stuck at home. So I guess this is number 16 in our series, and we are tying the atoms. This is a classic pattern. We're going to be tying this on a size 14 dry fly hook. We're going to be using the Veevus 8-aught black thread. Tailing, or the tail, will be a dry fly tailing feather from the pack, both in brown and grizzly. Body is going to be the micro fine dry fly dub Baetis gray. Don't make the mistake that I almost just made and use the tan. I had to double check myself. And then our wings are going to be some grizzly feathers from the hen neck. And the hackle, we'll be using those dry saddle hackles, both grizzly and brown once again. This is a fun classic pattern to tie. It might take a couple rounds of practice to get there, but ultimately, in the end, this is one for the books. All right, so let's go ahead and slide over to the vise. All right, so in our vise, we have our size 14 dry fly hook. Let me make sure it's in there nice and level. If it looks like it's slightly off on the camera, I can assure you for me it's nice and level. The camera might just be a little off. So here we go. Size 14 dry fly hook. And thread, we are using the 8-aught. Black Veevus. So I have the camera kind of pretty close to the vise, so bear with me here. We're going to start our thread right here about that eye's length behind the eye. Eye. And we'll just take a few locking wraps. And we'll trim off that tag end. Nice and close. And we'll continue our thread wraps down the shank of the hook all the way towards the bend. Be mindful of that tip of that hook. We're going to park it right there. All right, so for our tailing feathers, or tail feathers, we're going to go to this dry fly tailing feathers pack. So we got a couple of different colors in here. So I've pulled out a brown, and I've pulled out a grizzly. One of each. And just to keep things in good practice, I'm just going to find that fluffy fuzz stuff, the downy portion, and we're just going to strip that off and just get that out of the way. It's always good to just kind of dress your feathers, dress your material as you tie along. A little bit more. Alright, so we're going to take ourselves strip 6 to 8 of each of these little barbules. We're going to take, I don't know, a small little clump. We'll just set the rest off to the side. We're going to get back to that. We're going to start with a little bit of brown. I'm going to go about one hook's length. I'm going to do one soft wrap to capture it. More locking wraps, making sure that stays right on top. Alright, up next we're going to add some grizzly, so we got to prepare our grizzly feathers. Same thing, I'm just going to get all this stuff out of the way. Same thing. Let's go ahead and just take a dozen or so. I'm gonna set that right on top of that. Same thing, a couple soft wraps, one soft wrap to capture it, a couple more with increased tension. Okay, so we have brown, grizzly, and we're gonna add a little bit more brown right on top of that. So a brown, grizzly brown sandwich for our tail. Almost like an Oreo cookie. Soft wrap to capture it. A couple more lock and wraps. Alright, we'll go ahead and wrap forward. I think that'll do us. Alright, after we trim those off, turn the page. Alright, now we're going to head on over to our hen neck, grizzly hackle. So go ahead and slide that out of the bag. Easier said than done. Alright, so I am going to actually go down here towards the base, or towards where the smaller feathers are. We're going to pick out two of these. Let's see here. We're not looking for the absolute smallest. We're just going to end up using the tips. Let's go. I think these two might be it. I'll go a little bit smaller on the next feathers. Kind of nice when you have the whole pack. Alright, these are it right here. There's the money. There's our two feathers. What we want to do is we want to measure that out so it's going to be one hook's length. I'm just going to get a visual. I'm going to go one hook's length, and I'm just going to go down to that next little bar. I'm going to just cut that feather. Set the tip off to the side, and the same thing. I'm going to measure that out. One hook, and then I'm going to go to that next line. This is kind of the tricky part. We're going to take these two little tips. Match up the tips, and we want them to splay out like a little V. Thread for just a little bit. I'm going to tie these in up front. Do one soft wrap to capture it. A couple more wraps. Now I'm going to wrap towards the rear. I'm going to lift these up. I have to go forward just a little bit. We went just a little bit too big. We're going to have to shorten these up a little bit. my fatal mistake there. I trimmed off my feather. Don't do what I just did. Let's grab two more feathers. You know when you do something and you don't know why you do it, but your brain told you to do it? That's what I just did. I've got two more feathers. One. Two. I just needed a lot more to hang on to. Here we go. So now we can actually line up those tips just a little bit better. I'm going to spin my bobbin counterclockwise, anti-clockwise. That helps my thread stay a little bit closer to my fingertips. Small little dam, because this is how we want those wings to sit. We want those wings to sit up. And that's going to be it. All right. Once our wings are secured up front and sitting up loud and proud, we'll go ahead and work our way to the rear. We're going to grab our dubbing. Microfine dry fly dub Baetis gray. So yeah, my little experience with those wings. Listen, this is the truth, guys. I've never claimed to be perfect and never claimed to be the greatest. I've always just claimed to be myself. And sometimes we struggle through things. And that first batch of wings, I don't know why, but I really struggled with that. But we got through it. If you have if you come across an easier technique, by all means, go for it. There probably is a better way. There always is a better way. So we're gonna grab a little bit of the dubbing. Less is more. More or less. A small little pinch, because we're just gonna dub the back half of this fly. As we put on our dubbing, it's a one-way dub. Keep it sparse, as we know, sparse is nurse. Take the dubbing noodle to the back. Nice tight wraps. Now we're going to slightly build a slightly tapered body. We're going to go right about to the halfway point on this hook. Not quite to the wing. We're giving ourselves as much space as we have in front of the wing as behind the wing. Keep things nice and even. All right, up next, here we go. We're gonna grab our saddle hackles. Wow, those are fun. Let's go ahead and get those out of the bag. Let's go ahead and grab one of each. One brown, one grizzly. Alright, we're going to tie each of these in. Start off down at the base. Mm-hmm. we kind of coax this feather out to wake it up a little bit. Not stripping the barbs off, I'm just opening that up a little bit. Alright, right here at the very end, and do our high and tight notch on either side. Top side of the feather, we're going to tie that up and out. Behind the wing, just in front of the dubbing. Just take a couple soft wraps to capture it. A couple more locking wraps. Wash, rinse, and repeat. We're going to do the same with this grizzly. Carefully kind of wake up the bottom end. See how it's going to splay out for us. All right. A little notch on either side of the stem. Same thing, we're going to tie it top side out. One soft wrap to capture it, and a couple more locking wraps. And then we'll bring our thread forward. Ooh, that's intense. This is fun. I you know, when you're so used to tying big flies, and my typical world, I'm typically tying bass flies. This is fun tying these small flies. Alright, let's go ahead and palmer forward our hackle, because let's synchronize our watches. It's hackle time. No hackle pliers needed with these nice big long feathers, but we're going to take nice and even wraps stacked right in front of each other. We're going to do our best to keep these splayed out in the same direction, having the front forward. One, two, three, four wraps behind. Make sure we get right in front of that wing. I think mine got twisted in the mix somewhere, but that's all right. Let's go ahead and hold our feather up and to the right. I'm just going to take a couple of locking wraps behind, and then one wrap in front. Gonna trim off my excess, save the remainder of that feather for the next round. As well. So this is where the handy little half hitch tool is going to come in. At the end of some of these bodkins, they have this little hole. And it's great for just kind of holding material back. I'm just going to use that to help me get a wrap or two. A little head up front. instead of a whip finish, I'm just going to do the half hitch. Over there and slide that loop off. Make sure it gets up and over and past that eye. Do that a couple more times. So that's the gist of it. We're going to add a little dab of head cement, a little bit of this Loon Outdoors water-based, and we're going to use our bodkin to apply that. We just want one little drop on there. So that is the atoms. As tied by me. Is it perfect? Probably not. I'll never say it's perfect atoms. I really don't tie too many of these. This is kind of a refresher of a classic pattern. But a little bit of practice, we'll get this looking really good. So let's go ahead and set this one off to the side and we'll try take two. What do you say? This isn't a quick, fast, and a hurry tie, but it is what it is. Let's go ahead and reset take two. Go ahead and secure that size 14 hook. Start with our thread about an eye's length behind the eye. Aye. Alright, we'll continue our thread wraps to the rear. And a nice little thread base. Up next, we are looking for our dry fly tailing feathers. And what do you know? I just happen to have some left over from our first one. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab a couple of barbs. Six or so. Who's really counting? Start with the brown. Let's go to hook's length. One soft wrap to capture it. A couple more locking wraps. There we go. And our next layer, which will be some of this grizzly. Make sure it stays on top. And then we'll add some more brown. Some brown, grizzly brown. forward. I'll trim off whatever little bits we got remainder. Do a little bit bigger hackle on these ones. A little bit bigger wings. Top sides in. This is what I forgot. Yeah, this is so much better. I don't know why I didn't do this the first time. Match up the tips. Fold the material back. A little bit smaller. Wraps towards the rear, we'll trim off our excess. Wrap. Don't need to do too many of them. Usually just one will do. Once we've got our wing up, we'll go ahead and get ready to add our dubbing. And as we know, we're going to be using our Microfine Dry Fly Dub Baetis Gray. Less is more, more or less. Let's keep it sparse. That is nice. Make a small little dubby noodle. Do a slightly tapered body. Slightly tapered. We're not going to quite go all the way to the wing. We're going to stay back just a little bit. Thread halfway between the body, the dub, and the wings. We're going to grab our saddle hackle, this nice long hackle again. We're gonna do our little high and tight down here at the base. Tie this behind the hackle, or behind the wing. We're going to wrap the thread back a couple of wraps. Take it all the way to the dubbing. side up or top side out. Alright, let's go ahead and palmer our grizzly hackle forward first. A few wraps behind the wing. Trim that off nice and close, and then we'll wash, rinse, and repeat with this brown hackle. Let's work it right in there, a few wraps behind, and a few wraps. Pretty darn good. Let's go ahead and just go right into that wet finish. Not wet finish, but we're going to do half hitches. Trim off that tie and thread nice and close. And a little dab of glue, yeah. A little bit of this Loon Outdoors water-based head cement. Get one little drop on the bodkin. And let it soak right into that thread. Beautiful. So that is the Adams. Welcome to the family. See what I did there? That was a corny joke. So yeah, as you can tell, we kind of didn't do the best on the first one, but the second one I think came out a lot better. I'm just going through these kits, through the materials, like I'm a beginner. So, let's go ahead and wrap this up. That is the Adams. Up next, believe it or not, it's probably going to be a little bit easier pattern for me to tie. It is a light Cahill parachute. You think this type of fly was fun? Just wait till we start making parachutes. So yeah, stay tuned. Up next, light Cahill parachute. Thank you for watching. I want you all to stay healthy, stay safe, happy tying, and yeah, sure, you betcha. Tie lines. Peace.